Good morning, guys. Welcome to Captain German Offshore Sailing YouTube channel. Today, I would like to tell you about a really cool family. Behind me, you can see Catamaran Nautitech 46, and this family is sailing on a catamaran around the world following waves because they are surfers family. So about that family, I would like to make story, and today we will be able to watch that movie. So go ahead. Hi, good afternoon.
Hey guys.
Hi, may I have permission to get on board?
Of course.
Thank you. Hi. So, you know me, my name is Sergi. So, what is your name?
Susanna.
Susanna.
Ilya.
Ilya.
Sid.
Sid.
Oh, okay.
And here we have...
Man, what is your name?
Kai.
Kai.
And
what is your name?
Sasha.
The fisherman.
Great,
the
fisherman.
The young fisherman just back from the mission.
Now we will start discussion about that cool family. Go ahead.
Then everybody feel like, oh my god, what kids can do and how can you live with kids on board? And
how can you survive on board, yes, with the kids?
And then like we see you and we see this extreme energy running around like busy all the day and think, oh my god, this is the best example you can see, because you know it's not everybody have that much entertainment and enjoy.
No, I know, we're the entertainment for everybody.
So about this one we will speak today. I see you have a big family.
Yes.
How it's possible to travel? Because as I know, the people say like, oh, traveling with the kids, I'm afraid, we just afraid to do this. How it's possible?
Well, you just put them on a boat and go. No, it's nothing special. Sometimes you think you need a lot of things and...
Yes, that's...
No, it's just clothes, food and some toys. Important, the toys.
So makes them busy
toys
all the
is
time.
Very important.
Yeah, a lot of boards and bicycles and...
Yeah, skateboards, surfboards.
And
we have even have an Optimist.
Optimist?
Optimist.
Okay.
Optimist.
He's
the captain of the Optimist.
So okay. you can sail on Optimist?
Yeah.
How old are you?
13.
Cool.
That's the new captain.
Yeah.
Already.
Yeah, yeah. It's the segundo capitán.
A friend of mine said, if you want your kids never go on a sailing boat, buy an Optimist.
Ah. What do you think about it? Is it true?
No.
Probably motorcycle riding after Optimist.
No, but he used to ride motorcycle as well.
I saw in this video which you show me.
Yeah.
It's crazy. That's you, the guy.
I'll show you
the circles.
I'll show you the video. It's a really cool one.
Yeah, he used to ride motorcycle.
And Sasha too.
Sasha as well. They both have motorcycles.
Off-road. Motocross.
Motocross.
Motocross. Me too.
And
that's
used to race in the yard in Hawaii, because we lived in Hawaii for the past 6 years. Okay. I wanted a monohull. My first intention was to buy a monohull, but then because we are so many and we needed more space.
We two of us cannot go with monohull and all the toys. You know, like surfboards, you have to hide somewhere. Scooters, you have to hide somewhere,
And this is big, this is very big, but...
Which size is it?
It's a 46.
46, yeah. 46, okay.
Yeah, but for the amount of toys we carry, it's starting to get small. Because we have... We have two standard paddle boards, five surfboards.
But it's a different for different sizes, different condition for beginners.
Yeah.
For people who can do it.
Yeah, for people who can do it.
Uh huh.
And then we have two windsurf boards, six sails, I don't know how many masts and booms and the Optimist.
But you said that you like windsurfing.
Yes.
Why you prefer windsurf, not kitesurfing?
Because it's harder to windsurf than to kite.
So kite is more easy, so you prefer something more physical, so you
not physical, more technical.
More technical.
Yeah.
So, but yeah. I saw you just doing it very fast.
The
on
windsurf.
A windsurf. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
And big waves.
We only do windsurf in big waves. Only if there's no waves, we do no windsurf.
Okay. So you need a bad weather, really bad weather for doing it.
No, we just need like the wave we were surfing the other day.
Uh-huh. No, that's fine. Yeah,
with
a
little wind, side of wind, and that's it. And then we go. And we
do steering wheel on a port starboard. Is it comfortable to do it from here?
I think it's very comfortable.
But why don't you like a flybridge?
Because your boom automatically gets higher.
Yes, and a low performance.
Yes, and
okay, it's reasonable.
And I don't like it. I'm an architect. Look the aesthetics as well.
Uh-huh.
And I don't like it when you have a higher boom.
No, this boat is very beautiful. Yeah.
That was basically it. Although I have to say, once you go onto a flybridge, it's also nice to be up there.
Yeah.
But what I really like about this one is that I can be here on the helm. And I'm in the living room at the same time.
Yeah, you with the people.
I'm with the people. I don't have to climb up or feel separate, you know?
Yes, because over there, definitely you will be separate.
You'll be separate. Even here, if it's windy, you know, there's bad weather, I mean, you're still here, inside. I have more control on my kids when it's,
yes, that's
when
important.
It's rough weather, you know? So if I'm here or there, no one can go out unless I see him. Yeah.
Yeah, it's safety.
Safety.
Yeah. So you have Nautitech?
Yeah, we have a Nautitech.
Great boat. Why do you choose this one but not Lagoon or Fontaine Peugeot or something?
Because the Lagoon is a heavier, slower boat.
Yes, it's like a boathouse.
Yes, and we chose this one especially because it had a lower boom.
Uh-huh.
And no flybridge.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't like the flybridge. So I
like. But it's a more high performance.
Size. Yes.
Yeah, so yes. You can go more upwind than another.
The plan is never to go upwind.
Nobody loves it, but just in case.
Just in case, I suppose I could. I don't know. I mean, we haven't tested it like how it goes upwind seriously. Upwind, no. Because we've always been sailing downwind pretty much. If it's not, the forecast is not right, we don't go.
But it is just...
That's the cool philosophy. I keep telling him, you know, because I really want to live on Catamaran. That's how I feel, you know, I need my studio and everything. And
but for us, we already made one round the world,
yes,
you know. Just for us,
like
it's, we need just to calm down.
And flow, you know. It's always some good current and some good wind situation.
But you know, in a monohull, if you see not really good weather, you think like, okay, but why should I wait? Go, you know, like, okay, go, you know, because you can. You know?
Yes, but then it can get uncomfortable as well.
Yes.
And I travel with kids.
Do everything with a father, just surfing and
Sky Devlin.
No, I saw them go fishing one day without everybody.
No, he goes on himself as well.
Yes.
He doesn't need me all the time.
Last year was my dad.
And after some period of time, my daughter came to me. She was 14.
Yeah.
15. She finished secondary school and she joined me. And many people start to say like, come on, what about the education? So that's very common question of people.
Yes, I mean, I was worried. I mean, me and my wife, we were worried at the beginning because of education.
Yes.
It was our main concern. But then since then we learned that there's many programs you can follow and offline. You don't need to be connected to
mm-hmm.
internet. So they sent you all the material.
Uh-huh.
Kids have to complete it. When it's complete, you send mm-hmm. it back. And usually it's all good. And then they pass to the next
course.
There's no time here for school, you know. Usually there's fishing, diving, surfing, optimist, something going on.
But this education is much better than regular school.
So much better. Like, this is the best education.
That now we start with the geography. Yeah. So like, come on, open passport and take, check where you've been and visa.
visas.
Yes.
No, but you change, like, you see different cultures in a matter of a few days.
But what is your favorite toys?
Tell us.
Surfing.
Surfing. Really surfing.
But I'm not the one wheel.
No.
How many boards do you have?
One.
Two.
A windsurf board and a surfboard.
Sasha, what about
the
you?
The small one and the bigger one?
What?
Which toy do you like? Like surfing, fishing, motorcycle?
Dinghy.
Motorcycle you like more. Dinghy? Can you ride dinghy?
No.
No? Well, but I saw you can.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw. So brave, sit like do whatever they need, like right out. Like,
fishing.
I even film you on a telephone because it was so cool. Like, you know, adult, self confident, sit, go, cool.
Yes, I started windsurfing.
Uh huh.
And since then, I've been windsurfing all my life.
But what do you do next? Why you start to live in Hawaii? What's the reason of it? Just because of work, business, or just
business? Fish? We bought two pieces of land during the recession they had in 2009 or 2010, I think, and it was very cheap. The euro was
high
and the dollar was low, so it was a lucky thing. And then I'm an architect.
So your profession is an architect?
Yes, my profession is an architect.
You don't look like an architect.
Yes, and so I invested all the money I earned during my working in building a house in Hawaii.
Uh-huh.
And now we're selling it. And
it was like a development project.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, now we sold the house and then we start selling.
Great. So what is your next plan? What are you going to do?
Our next plan is to find all the ways we can surf in the world.
Guys, where do you like more? So all your route, where have you been sailing?
It was fun. We kite surfed with our friends and went. Oh, and one day there was waves and went surfing and
those
really nice waves.
Where it was?
In Barbuda.
In Barbuda. In Barbuda.
Palmetto Point.
And where was your best place? Tell us. Most favorite.
Hawaii.
Hawaii?
No, but with a boat, with a sailboat.
Hawaii is also a good answer.
Santa Lucia.
Huh?
Santa Lucia. Cool.
And now I think it is time to ask Ilya about surfing.
I don't know, we started surfing when I was a kid, and since then we've been surfing all our life. It's been what has decided where we're going to live, what we're going to do. It's always based on waves. So yeah, we were born in Mallorca, and because of the waves we moved to Canary Islands, then we moved to Hawaii, and then we finally bought a boat, and our mission is to go surf all the waves we can find. Well, I do windsurf as well. I've done kitesurfing, I've done many things, and surfing is different because it's just you, the board, and there's nothing else, just the energy of the wave. So you don't use wind power, you don't use a paddle, you just go with the energy of the wave. You feel freedom, you don't know exactly why, but you feel a lot better after you have surfed. You leave all the bad energy behind and you come out of the water super happy and smiling, and everything is good after surfing. No, it's not boring. No, it's, I don't know what it is, but it's maybe an adrenaline rush, and you get addicted to that, and you just search for it every day, every day, every day, with every wave you can take. It's, I don't know how to describe it. It's a good feeling.
Sometimes it's hard and you get really bored because you can't find a wave to catch, but when you catch it, you just want to go another, you just want to get another wave and another one, and it's hard to describe. So fun in that moment that you just want to do it again. Oof. I caught my first wave when I was, I don't remember, like two? No, not two. Like four maybe. And then I didn't surf for a long time. And then we moved to Hawaii and that's when I started surfing. Hawaii was the beginning of me being a surfer. It's really fun when you're doing it with friends. It's fun surfing with a couple friends, but if there's just like 50 people out in the water, it's kind of frustrating because you're trying to catch a wave and there's someone already on the wave. And if you catch that wave, he gets mad and it's, I don't know. But if it's just two, three people, you have a much higher chance of getting a wave. And surfing with friends is kind of funny because you sometimes see them trying to go under the wave and you just see the board flinging up and it's fun. Happy, relaxed, and thinking about surfing. Oh,